These are just a few of the 35,511 registered overseas absentee voters from the eastern states of America under the jurisdiction of the Philippine Embassy in Washington, D.C., who are hoping to make their votes count in the May 9 Philippine presidential elections.
Hopefully, even though we're not a lot, but it's still going to add to the numbers. So, yeah, we're here and we're going to vote.
Mary Fuchsia Mariano is one of the organizers of this Kakampink Lab and Leni and Kiko event in Orlando, Florida.
I want her to be open. I want her to tell us exactly what is going on with the China issue, with the Marcos issue, with the tax evasion issue. I want her to tell us those things that are being hidden from us.
Roque Barrido, who traveled 2 hours from Clearwater, is another Robredo supporter.
In the last 6 years, sinusundan ko siya. Nakita ko kung gaano siya katapat. She's the president that can flip the pyramid.
The Washington, D.C. office handles ballots for residents in 11 states, for seafarers and Caribbean islands, including St. Kitts and Nevis, where Jexel Alcaraz is the lone registered voter there.
It was actually quite overwhelming, but I'm also very happy that I get to register. And then even though I am far away from home, I think my voice can still be heard.
Alcaraz tells ABS-CBN News she is using this time to encourage fellow Filipinos on the island to register and vote next time. Meanwhile, ABS-CBN News has reached out to supporters of other Philippine presidential candidates in the Florida area, but so far, we have not heard of any events in this region. Lenn Almadin-Thornhill, ABS-CBN News, Orlando, Florida.